Good morning, African Stars International School learners. I'm Miss Homa, your grade 6 nature science teacher. Welcome to your nature science e-learning lesson 6, STEM 2. Our topic for today is clean water. Now, clean water is known as potable water, okay, which is a water that is safe to drink. So potable water is water that is safe to drink, okay. How is it made safe to drink? It is made by removing all impurities or pollutants in the water. Now, polluted water, okay, so now this one is a water that contains harmful things or impurities, okay. And another word for polluted water is waste water. Now let's talk about the danger of polluted water, okay. So polluted water can cause diseases because many living organisms in polluted water causes diseases such as diarrhea, cholera, and typhoid fever, okay. And then they can also be poisonous because dissolved chemicals and metals in the water can be poisonous to people and animals, okay. And it can also cause eutrophication. Now, eutrophication is simply just the excessive richness of nutrients in lakes or rivers that cause dense growth of plants. So what happens? The water might have too much nutrients, okay, and then these nutrients can then make what? Can then make plants to grow what? To grow rapidly, okay. So we have many plants what? In the lakes and rivers. Okay, so water purification techniques. So how can we purify water? How can we make water clean? We can make water clean by decanting or by filtering or by distilling, boiling, or chlorination. Now, decanting. Okay, now this one, it depends on gravity, okay, to settle impurities at the bottom of the container, okay. So this process is useful for removing heavy solids such as sand and stones from water. So maybe when you have water that has sand and stones, you can purify this water by decanting, because at the end of the day, these stones will be at the bottom of the container and you are able to remove the water, okay. The other one is filtering, okay. Now this one, it depends on the size of the impurities, okay. It depends on the size of the impurities, okay. So the dirty water is poured through a filter, okay. Then water particles pass through the holes in the filter, and then the large impurities are left behind in the filter, okay. So filtering is useful for removing large particles of impurities such as leaves, litter, and also sand, okay. So this is filtering can also be used when you have water with impurities such as leaves, litter, and sand, and then this one is done using a filter, okay. So you pour the water through the filter, and then the impurities will then left behind in the filter. So this process is called filtering, and is also one way of purifying water. The other way is distilling. Now this one, it depends on the way that water changes from liquid to gas when it is heated, okay. So then when water is heated, it evaporates into water vapor, and then this leaves the impurity behind as crystals, okay. Now pure water is collected, okay, and condensed back into water by cooling it, okay. And then now distilling is useful for separating pure water from almost any impurities, okay. It may contain such as solid and dissolved chemicals and metals, okay. So distilling also kills any living organism in water. So basically what happens during a distilling, so water is heated and then it evaporates, then it leaves what the impurities behind in a form of crystals, okay? And then when it's heated, remember when water is heated, it forms what? It forms water vapor. Now this water vapor is then what? Condensed back so that it can form water, okay? Now this water that is formed is referred to as pure water, okay? Or sometimes, since distilling involves heating, it can also kill what? Kill any living organism in water, leaving it clean, or let's say pure, in other words. Now there's also purification by boiling, okay? So remember this one, we boil, but then we condense what? We condense that water, okay? Or we cool that water so that it turns back to what? We heat the water, it forms water vapor, then that water vapor, we cool it down to form pure water. Now let's talk about purification by boiling, okay? Here, heat is also involved. So, boiling can also be used as a technique to kill living organism in polluted water, okay? So here, boiling involves heating 200 degrees Celsius for like 10 minutes. So you boil the water at 100 degrees Celsius, okay, for at least 10 minutes, okay? Now, at this high temperature, most of living organisms in the water are killed, okay? So here, most of the living organisms that lives in that water are killed because boiling happens at what? At 100 degrees Celsius, and this is a very high temperature, so it can kill most of living organisms. Now, there's also purification by chlorination, okay? So, chlorination is a technique used to kill living organisms such as bacteria and algae, okay? Now, chlorination is used in water purification plants to disinfect water, okay? So, what is used here is chlorine, okay? And chlorine is a chemical that kills microorganisms. So the chemical that is the chlorine that is used to disinfect or to purify water is not too much that it can what? It can harm us, okay? So that's why it is what? It is safe, okay, to purify the water for the people to drink. Yes, now just a few steps to disinfect water at home. Okay, so what you can do, you can add 1 teaspoon of bleach to 20 liters of water, and then you let the water stand overnight or for at least 2 hours, and then you keep the water covered to keep out to keep out flies and dirt, okay? And then that's it for today, okay? The activity for today is found in our textbook on page 83, topic 4 assessment, whereby you only answer number 7 and number 8. Number 7 says, describe the difference between decanting and filtering. And also in number 3, write down the scientific process that you would use to separate dissolved salts from water. So we have come to the end of today's lesson. Remember to stay safe, stay at home. Wash your hands and avoid overcrowded places, and please wear your mask when you go out of the house so that we can help fight COVID-19.